I was a child during a time when domestic violence against women was a shameful secret. Everyone knew about it. Everyone within the community knew where it was happening, but nobody was doing anything about it. And within the immediate family circle, it was so shameful and embarrassing an aspect of your home life that no one wanted it exposed or discussed. The end result was that it continued, and there was no attempt either from the authorities or within the community itself to diminish it. I experienced firsthand violence against my mother from an angry and unhappy man who was not able to control his emotions nor his hands. And the harm done by those events, of course, the physical harm, the physical scars that were left, the blood that was shed, the wounds that were exposed to a shocking pain. But there are other aspects of violence which have more lasting impact psychologically on family members. It is destructive and tainting. As a child witnessing these events, one cannot help somehow feeling responsible for them, for the pain and the screaming and the misery. And it is deeply confusing, and those confusions are not things which are easily disposed of in adult life. They stay with you. And you are given, a child is given a very bad lesson in male responsibility, self-control. And I know that in my own life, in the past, I have had issues in relationships with women in my life which have a history in the experiences that I had as a child in my own home. It is a worldwide phenomena, and in places, in countries of a much more severe and destructive form than anything that I experienced. And it's one of the reasons why the campaign which Amnesty International is spearheading to bring people's attention to domestic violence is so important, because it is here among us, and it is certainly in the world at large. So far as the authorities are concerned, there have been great advances, and there needed to be, because as a child I heard police officers in my home say, well, she must have provoked him. And I heard doctors who came to treat my mother say, well, Mrs. Stewart, it takes two to make a fight. They had no idea. Today, we're much more sensitive to these issues, but not sensitive enough. Still, these things are hushed up. Still, people don't talk about. Still, the violence is allowed to continue. And one way in which this deeply troubling element in modern life can be opposed is through government intervention. I would like to see our government taking as seriously issues of violence against women. And these issues are huge, because here in the UK, almost 50% of all adult women claim that they have been the victims of domestic violence, sexual abuse, or stalking. So I would like to see these issues taken as seriously by the government as quite properly they take issues of drunk driving, violence against minors, and their smoking campaigns. more sensitive to these issues, but not sensitive enough. Still, these things are hushed up. Still, people don't talk about it. Still, the violence is allowed to continue. And one way in which this deeply troubling element in modern life can be opposed is through government intervention. I would like to see our government taking as seriously issues of violence against women. And these issues are huge because here in the UK, almost 50%
Thank you.